Hey YouTubers, welcome to DeBoer Star Trek Enterprise Refit Prop Reproduction Update number 20. Today's one of those mixed bags. Although I have some cool stuff to show on the Enterprise, I just got news a few hours ago that my good friend Henry Prentice from TSDS Inc., the guy who does fantastic decals, I mean my Enterprise is basically mostly his decals, me and him designed the, or Henry and I developed the UFX board, and good friend for over 10 years, wonderful guy. Had been having a lot of medical problems. He was a big, heavy set man, and his legs swelled up. Something was going on there, some kind of reaction, virus, who knows. And he was just getting out of the hospital, got home, and had a very, very serious heart attack. Apparently, he technically died for a while. They resuscitated him with a defibrillator, and he has possibly got some very serious brain damage because he was without air for a while. And right now he's in intensive care, and Henry's up in Virginia, by the way, and it doesn't look good. His brain scans are not showing a whole lot of activity. He's non-responsive. They're going to do a final one tomorrow. And I'm sorry to Henry and his family. I extend, you know, my best wishes, and I've offered help if I need to. And a lot of you guys may know who Henry Prentice is. He's a very funny guy on the phone. My God, what a comedian. He's one of the few guys who could top me with some stupid puns, and I got to give him that. We used to play the insult game and to see who would get mad, but we liked each other so much nobody got mad, which is really cool. I don't mean to ramble. However, you know, if you know Henry, send him, you know, good wishes, good vibes. Send him his wife an email, Carol, who's having a really hard time, and I'd appreciate it. On another note, it's not been the best week. Let's see, Casadega, if you recall, and I posted this on Facebook, some of you already know it. Of course, you know, I have different audiences. YouTube audiences are one. Some people just go strictly to my website. I never know, so I tell you guys, yes, I have a Facebook page. You can access my Google Plus and Facebook page on YouTube at the About, you know, the About section, which tells you about the person or whatever, and there's links to that in case you want to keep up with that. Casadega. Well, as I wrote in my article, run by a bunch of ninnies. I swear, I'm on the phone, it's like, well, Mr. Burks, we don't, you know, we decided not to let you film, and, you know, that kind of crap. Sounded like some elitist rich woman that runs the local gardening club or the Rose Club, you know, one of those deals. In the movies, they're always portrayed as these just seriously demented ninnies that are all about status and holding the pinky up. And 5 weeks, you know, we're negotiating back and forth, back and forth, back and forth on me going there. And finally, the Monday of this prior week, well, we're looking at Saturday and everything looks good, and I'll get in touch before the end of the week. Yeah, well, you know, it's Friday afternoon. I haven't heard a word from her. I called her all day. I'm getting voicemail. And I had to write to her in an email and say, look, you know, by 5, 6 p.m. tonight, we just don't have enough time to prep all the equipment. I mean, you got to do a lot of stuff to get, you know, a non-location going. I mean, several hours work. Check the batteries, put in batteries, check the equipment, you know, get the van ready, whatever. Lots of stuff. And she calls, and I said 5 to 6 p.m. or else after that, you know, there's just no way. Calls exactly 1 hour after dead time, 7 p.m., and tells me, well, we got our 125th anniversary coming up and blah, 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 and all these other excuses, you know, basically beating around the bush, which they did for 5 weeks. I wish 5 weeks ago that we just said, no, you're not really what we want promoting us. And I've been okay with that. At least you're honest. You don't waste my time. But she let me down the primrose path, you know. And calls at 7 o'clock and says, now the board's denied your filming right. And I, you know, the whole time we're talking, she's talking about compensation for the mediums, which I don't know, you know, no problem. I even offered to make a donation because they do take donations and all that, trying to be nice, very polite throughout the whole thing, even though I'm talking to one of these. You know, and I just went, but politeness, you know, we ask first. So Casadega isn't happening. However, if you recall, we went to the St. Augustine Lighthouse. We did the lighthouse, and then what you guys didn't catch is at the end when we left and talked to Matt, who's the director for the chores over there, told us that the cottage, and there's quite a lot of structure on the other side of the lighthouse, the cottage of the lighthouse keeper, which is reputedly even hotter than the lighthouse itself. There's a workshop where in World War I or II they repaired Jeeps. Quite a big compound, and apparently that's even more active. So we're working on doing the St. Augustine Lighthouse compound, paranormal investigation number 2. So we didn't give up on it. We just think Casadega is like, we're not interested anymore. You know, if we're not going to be welcome after all the effort we put in, you know, don't need to. There's plenty of haunted locations all over the state, Georgia, whatever, where we need to go. So anyways, moving on. Today, what we have to show, yes, that's the blah for now. What we have to show is actually having mounted the Enterprise secondary hull with a rod that will allow the wiring and all that to go down through. We've cut out a whole lot of stuff, and we're getting ready to glass. And I wanted to show you a few things about that, how that was done, and how I consider something to be secured on a post, especially something this big. I mean, you can get away with just epoxying for the small ones, but on the bigger ones, you gotta do some hardware work, and I'll show you how I modify copper plate for copper plumbing into what's called a flowered mount. So we'll go on from there. Okay. All right, so as you can see now, you can see fairly well, I got it lit as best I can, the inner plate. What it starts off as is a simple T-section copper pipe. It's cut down the center, and on an anvil with a hammer, just like old blacksmith days. My grandfather was actually a very good metal worker, so maybe it's genetic. Food for thought. And you open this out, which is where the flowering term comes out, till it matches the inside of the hull. It does take a while, and you have to be patient, but the tube matches exactly with the rod, and it gives you pretty good amount of space to get those wires through. The inside, if I can get a little closer here without turning the camera off like I did the first time. There we go. Ooh, so professional, Professor. There we go. So now you can see how the plate was done and how well it matches, and a very strong coupling. It's okay to just epoxy when you're dealing with a small model, but when you're dealing with something like this, it's going to weigh several pounds, especially once the, you know, everything's put on there and there's a whole lot of metal and everything. You need something strong. So there's actually about 5 or 6 layers of very strong epoxy. And then what I do, and it's still tight right now because I just, you know, matched up the tube. By the time I'm done, I will have filed this down so it's a very smooth, easy fit. But it works for now, and I want it to be tight now because of all the manipulation and things it's gonna have to endure. Notice I have countersunk 3 stainless steel Phillips head. Don't use regular metal because it will oxidize, even though it's mostly covered up. It's still a good idea. Stainless steel will not break on you like some cheap ones will. And there's our nub, which has been aligned with a 45 degree. And covered with a little bit of epoxy, but I'm gonna get it to the point where by the time I'm done priming and finishing this, you'll never know the bolts were there. And again, going straight through down in there to the plate. Very strong, and I feel secure going on. Also notice that it's not gonna block the arboretum, because if that rod goes all the way through the center, it becomes a problem. What else? Notice that the shuttle bay section is open. The top part of the shuttle bay, the actual doors are open. And just to give you a brief look, I think I may have showed this before or not. Elliott Brown's shuttles are just so perfect and in scale, and he's actually making up a few more for me. So the shuttle bay should be really nicely detailed. The one thing I'm working on, because I gotta stuff this on the bottom, I may have to widen this out to have a bit more mobility. And also, if you remember, there's structurals along the side. So that's something I'm gonna have to ponder, and if I have to draw it out for Elliot and all that, that's gonna be a big job. But once I get a good design for him, and I'm gonna have to do it in paper or cardboard first and hand him over those templates, it can be done, but it's a lot of work, and it's, I hadn't thought about that, and now I am, because now I'm there. I've got, you know, 90% of this thing pre-planned, but there is that 10% where things happen. Now, on this inner brass ring, it's a tough call because this is the sensor dish, hasn't been cut out in the center yet. You got an outer diameter, inner diameter, and then you got to have these perfect concentric holes, four large ovals, and six in between of the smaller ones. This part is actually going to be sent to Elliot, so he can actually have the part in front of him. In some cases, it's convenient to do that. In some cases, it's not. Since I've got the shuttle bay to work on, it'll be quite a time, 2, 3, 4 weeks maybe, before I get to this part. So that's convenient for our case. So anyways, you get a concept of where I'm at right now. A little bit how it was done. If you're not very good at working with metals and you have no skills with a drill or, you know, basically tool stuff, this would be a tough spot for you. But it's really just pure working with tools, mechanic side of it. I mean, there's many levels to this model. Some of them are very artistic. Some of them are just down in the ground beating the hell out of a piece of metal. So there's a lot involved. So hence people who think modeling is easy or it's a waste of time, I have news. So next,
I'm down here.
We have a very interesting video. Just the other day, we got a knock on the door. I'll be back next week. Take care, all.
Well, I'm really sorry. I took a lot of my chips that I won at the casino on the boat, and I kind of went into the engine room and I threw them all into the machinery. And the ship had to return to Port Canaveral. And let me tell you, it's been a hell of a walk. Oh man. Wait a minute. This place, it looks familiar. Holy Toledo, I think I'm home. Wait a minute. Yes. Yes, that's Papa Smurf's car. Goodness. I think I've found my way home. It's been a long year, boys and girls. Okay, so I think this sure looks like the place. Wow. What a weird feeling. People staring at me. Wonder why I look like everybody else. Oh yeah, man. This is the place. Oh my God, I'm home.
Yes, Papa Smurf, I am very sorry. I beg your forgiveness. It's been a long year. I've learned my lesson. I will never hurt another Smurf. No. Promise, just let me back in my little laboratory. Please be kind. I've learned my lesson. Seriously. Yes, please go get the keys to my laboratory. Thank you.
Oh, I think I'm in. Not sure. I don't see any...
Well, hello there, little Smurf. Yes, I'm back. Yes. What is that you say? Oh, you're going to mess it up for me, are you? Well. Why? I'll be good, I promise. You'll have none of it. Your brother and sister were incinerated in their attack. Well. Hello, Papa Smurf. No, it was a motorcycle back frame. You know, they tore on motorcycles, yes. So I'm all ears.